Everybody, welcome in. My name is DJ Hapa. They call me the DJ Coach. I'm excited that you are here. I'm excited to walk you through a full course using the DJ InPulse 200 that I have right here. I want to make sure that you have all the right materials, but before we do that, I also want to set your mind at ease about what you are about to learn. So we're going to go through a step-by-step process. This is meant for you to complete over 7 days. Some people do it faster. Some people take a little bit longer to do it. Either way, whatever you prefer, it's here for you. I'm here for you. And along this way, we are working towards a goal. That goal is to put together a 15-minute set that you're gonna put together all on your own using the fundamentals that I'm gonna teach you over the next 7 days. So I'm excited to have you. I'm excited to get going, but I wanna make sure that you have all the materials that you need. Number one, you need a DJ InPulse 200. Check. Number two, you need to have a laptop. Could be a Windows machine or a Mac. Either one works. And we'll go through some of the specs in just a moment. The other things that you could have that are optional are a set of speakers and some headphones. This is all you need to be able to get started. So let's jump in and make sure that we have the right software. If you haven't downloaded the software, follow me. We are gonna go to juiced.com. And as this pulls up, I'm going to click on download. And when I click on download, I have this form to fill out. So I wanna make sure to fill out this form on the left-hand corner. Write your name, your email, and the controller that you have. So the DJ InPulse 200, there we go. Say that you're not a robot. Download the link. Now what you're gonna get is an email to that same email address for you to complete the process. And while we're here, I want to just double check to make sure you have the right specs. So here are the recommended system requirements, and these are the minimum system requirements. So just double check that that's all good. Now I want you to check your email, go through the process, make sure that you install the software properly, and we'll come on right back. All right, so let's go ahead and open up Juiced. We are opening up the software, and you'll notice that this is also telling us the version number. This is version 5.0.4 at the time of recording this. And here we go. Now I need to plug in my controller. It gives me a couple of options. I can plug in my controller, I can go to demo mode, or I can unlock. And in this case, we already have our controller. We're gonna take this USB cable. I'm gonna plug this into my computer. Now, if you're on an older Mac, I mean a newer Mac, or a PC that takes a USB-C plug, you'll need to have an adapter. So make sure that you have an adapter. I use a hub. I'll show you this hub right here. This is what I use for my computer. But you can also get just those single ones that converts the USB to then USB-C. So now that I've plugged in my controller, you'll see that some of the lights come on a little bit and we are ready to go. Now the next question, and we're just gonna follow the prompt. The next question is, do you wanna use the controller output or the computer sound card? So I have the ability with Juiced to be able to play completely off of the laptop and not actually use the controller. Since I have the controller, we're gonna use the sound card in the controller and use the output of this. So I need this cable right here. This is our red and white RCA cable, and we're gonna say that that's what we're gonna use. Now we're gonna hit next, and it's gonna say to plug in our speakers now. So we're gonna go with this red and white RCA cable. I'm gonna come out of the actual controller, and I wanna make sure that these match. So white with white, red with red. Sometimes a good way to remember that is that the red is the right side. And then I'm going to plug this in to the back of my speaker. Now, I wanna show you these speakers. So these speakers, we've got two of them. One is an active speaker, this one, and the other one is a passive speaker. So the difference between the active and the passive is that the active speaker is the one that takes the input and also the power, and then the passive just gets connected to the active one. So we want to make sure to plug our red and white cables into the only way that they could go, which is into the active speaker. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug in the RCA cable into the active speaker. And now I also need power. So this comes with two different power plugs. One is for the US and the other one is for Europe and some of the other countries that are out there in Asia that takes this type of plug. So use the appropriate one. I'm gonna use the US one since I'm based here in Los Angeles. And I like to actually hold on to these cables. So I'm gonna hold on to this cable just in case. I don't know, I might need this one day, who knows? All right, so the next thing is I've got my one speaker plugged in, which is my active speaker. And now I can plug in the passive speaker if I want. So let me show you how this works. I'm gonna grab our speaker wire. This has red and black on it. And I'm gonna show you this right now. All right, so I'm gonna use the red and black speaker cable that this came with. And I am going to plug this into the active speaker. Black goes with black. I hold this down, put the cable in, and then release it. And then now I connect it to the other side for the passive speaker. But you don't need both speakers if you don't want. Like I'm actually, in this lesson today, I'm only gonna use one of the speakers. So I'm just gonna disconnect this for now. I'm gonna put this to the side and I'm only gonna use my active speaker. Now, you can if you're gonna use one speaker, you can only use the active speaker. You can't just use the passive speaker by itself. So we're gonna get that set up and we'll go on to the next step. All right, let's move on. So next, it says adjust our master volume. Our master volume is in the center of the controller, and you can see that here. I want to keep my master volume a little bit down. I don't want to put it all the way down. Look at this like a clock. So I'm going to have it set to about 12 o'clock, so straight up and down. And that'll ensure that I don't blow my speakers out. All right, so now we're gonna test our master volume and test our speakers. So make sure the power is switched on the back of your speaker. Also, there's a volume knob in the front of your speaker. Make sure to put that at about 12 o'clock as well. So straight up and down. And that knob is in right there in the front on the bottom left-hand corner. Can't miss it. And now what I wanna do is I wanna test this and I'm just gonna click on the right one because that is my active speaker. And I hear a sound, we're good to go. All right, next step, we are going to test our headphones. I still can't believe that all this stuff came in this one box. Now, when I grab my headphones, you'll notice that it has this gold adapter on it. This adapter we don't really need right now, so I'm gonna take this off. But don't throw this away because you can use this later, especially with other mixers that take a quarter inch plug, you're gonna want to have this, so don't throw it away. In fact, don't throw any of this stuff away. Just hold on to it for now. I'm gonna put this to the side though, because we're not gonna need this. All we're gonna need is this 1/8-inch jack, which is gonna go into the front of our controller. So let's plug it in. There's a little headphone icon, and then this fits perfectly in there. Let's test the headphones. I'm gonna go ahead and put the headphones on and test the left one and the right one. Great, we're good to go. Now, before we move on, you'll notice that there's one cable that we didn't use, and that's this cable right here. This is an RCA, the red and white RCA, to our 1/8-inch jack or a mini jack. Now, we don't need this because we're using our controller, but if we were just going to use our computer and go from the computer to the speaker, that's the cable that I would use. I can also use this cable for an iPad or a phone, as I can plug this little jack into the phone or iPad and go right into my speaker. So even at home, this could be a useful cable. So don't throw it away, hold on to it. Perfect, we are set up, we are ready to go. I am ready to start mixing, let's do it.